after action after a real event, and then, of course, prepare for events that unfortunately might befall us.
Let's turn to that meeting that the president held with a half dozen members of Congress on Thursday. They were discussing immigration from Africa, and according to Democratic Senator Dick Durbin, the president said this.
That's when he used these vile and vulgar comments, calling the nations they come from holes. The exact word used by the president, not just once, but repeatedly.
Secretary, you were in that meeting in the Oval Office. Did the president say that?
I don't recall him saying that exact phrase. I think he has been clear, and I would certainly say undoubtedly the president will continue to use strong language when it comes to this issue, because he feels very passionate about it. I think what was frustrating about that meeting for all of us in the meeting was that although the deal presented in theory an approach to the four pillars upon which we had agreed, did not address the core security issues that we need to do our job, and more importantly, there's nothing in there that would prevent us from getting here again. So we're not interested in half measures. We don't want additional temporary populations here. It's unfair to them, it's unfair to the American citizen, and it certainly raises security risks.
I don't understand. I'm going to just press back on you once on this subject. It seems to me you were in the meeting when these comments were made. I can understand you either saying they were said or they were not said. It is pretty shocking language, and to say I don't recall seems implausible. If the president of the United States used the word blank hole, talking about countries in the Oval Office, or didn't say it, I would know.
I understand the question. It was an impassioned conversation. I don't recall that specific phrase being used. That's all I can say about that.
There are several things about the president's comments, alleged comments, and there are both Republicans and Democrats who confirm that he said it, that disturb people. One is the president seems to be writing off people who come from black countries while he's saying we should take people coming from one of the whitest countries on earth, Norway. Here was a comment from an official at the UN Commission on Human Rights.
I'm sorry, but there's no other word one can use but racist. You cannot dismiss entire countries and continents as holes whose entire populations who are not white are therefore not welcome.
Isn't that the definition of racism, to say we don't want people from these black countries, but we do want people from a very white country?
I think what the president is saying is he'd like to move to merit-based, which is based on an individual. So what individuals can come here, can contribute to our society, help our economy, assimilate in communities, and help America be better. I take a little bit of offense to the comments and suggestions that the president is racist. What he's looking at is the exact merit-based system we have in Australia and Canada. And I'm sure that we are not, any of us, suggesting that Canada and Australia and their leaders are racist.
But the president seems in these comments to be equating merit to the countries that people come from. He seems to be suggesting you'd rather have a janitor from Norway than a doctor from Haiti.
I disagree. I think what he's trying to...
Why would merit have to do with the country? Why wouldn't it have to do with your qualifications?
I think it does. I think what he's trying to do is move away from a quota-based system, whether that's a quota of underrepresented countries or a quota of Norway, for example. I think what he's trying to say is we need to look at the individual and ensure that we look at those who can bring merit to our country.
All right. Let's turn to the practical implications.